Hello students, good afternoon. In the last class we have discussed about measures of dispersion. Measures of dispersion is also called as variation. It is also called as variation. In that there are totally two types of measures of dispersions are there. One is absolute measures of dispersion, second one is relative measures of dispersion. In absolute measures of dispersion there are four types. One is range, second one quartile deviation, third one mean deviation, and fourth one is standard deviation. Okay, the next, the relative measures of dispersion. Again there are four types. One is coefficient of range, coefficient of quartile deviation, coefficient of mean deviation, and coefficient of standard deviation. Okay, in that we have already discussed about range. We have already discussed about range and coefficient of range. Okay, now let us start. That is second one is, that is quartile deviation. Okay, and coefficient of quartile deviation. Okay, here quartile deviation is also called as a semi-interquartile range. Semi-interquartile range. Okay, then what is a quartile deviation? Okay, in the previous class we have already discussed about quartiles. Okay, what is a quartile? What is quartile? Okay, here the whole frequency distribution can be divided into four equal parts. The whole frequency distribution can be divided into four equal parts. Then it is said to be quartile. Okay, there are three quartiles are there. One is first quartile, second quartile, and third quartile. That is median. Okay, upper quartile, lower quartile, and median. Okay, Q1 is the lower quartile, Q2 is the median, and Q3 is the upper quartile. Okay, here what is a quartile deviation, or what is a semi-interquartile range? Okay, both are same. Semi-interquartile range. Okay, here interquartile range. What is the interquartile range? What is the interquartile range? Okay, interquartile range. Okay, here the difference between upper and lower quartile is said to be interquartile range. The difference between upper quartile and lower quartile is said to be interquartile range. Okay, here the difference between upper and lower quartile, the difference between the upper and lower quartile is called an interquartile range. That is, okay, here the quartile deviation, that is interquartile range, is equal to what? The difference between upper and lower quartile. Okay, upper quartile is denoted by here Q3 is the upper quartile. Q3 is the upper quartile and Q1 is the lower quartile. Q1 is the lower quartile. That is the difference. That is Q3 minus Q1 equal to interquartile range. Okay, here interquartile equal to Q3 minus Q1. The difference between the upper and lower quartile is said to be interquartile range. Now what is a semi-interquartile range? Semi means half. What is a semi-interquartile range? Okay, here interquartile range is the difference between upper and lower quartile is said to be interquartile. Then what is semi-interquartile range? Okay, here the half of the difference between upper and lower quartile is said to be semi-interquartile range, or the half of the interquartile range is said to be semi-interquartile range. Okay, here the half of the interquartile range is called semi-interquartile range. See, here the half of the interquartile range, that is here the semi-interquartile range is denoted by QD. Okay, here what is the quartile deviation? This, the half of the interquartile range is called quartile deviation. The half of the interquartile range, or the half of the difference between the upper and lower quartile, is said to be quartile deviation. The half of the upper and lower quartile is said to be semi-interquartal range. Okay, here both are same. Okay, here the quartile deviation or semi-interquartal range is denoted by QD. It is denoted by QD. Okay, here quartile deviation is denoted by QD. Then how to calculate quartile deviation? Okay, here QD equal to Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. It is the half of the interquartal range, half of the interquartal. What is inter? That is difference between upper and lower quartile. Okay, it is said to be quartile deviation. QD equal to Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. Okay, the next concept, what is the coefficient of quartile deviation? Coefficient of QD, quartile deviation. What is the coefficient of quartile deviation? Okay, here the relative measure of the quartile deviation is called coefficient of quartile deviation. Okay, here what is the coefficient of quartile deviation? The relative measure of the relative measure of quartile deviation. The relative measure of quartile deviation is called coefficient of QD. See here, the relative measure of quartile deviation is called coefficient of quartile deviation. Then how to calculate coefficient of quartile deviation? Here coefficient of QD equal to Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. Here the coefficient of quartile deviation can be calculated as Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. What is the here? The relative measure of the quartile deviation is said to be coefficient of quartile deviation. It can be calculated as coefficient of QD equal to Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. Okay, it is about quartile deviation and coefficient of quartile deviation. Okay, the next one is merits and demerits of quartile deviation. Merits and demerits of quartile deviation. What are the merits of a quartile deviation and drawbacks, demerits of a quartile deviation? Okay, here the first one is merits of quartile deviation. Here the merits of quartile deviation. Okay, here the first merit is it is easy to understand and simple to calculate. Okay, here the procedure is very easiest and simple to understand. Here it is easy to understand and simple to calculate. Okay, the next second one, second merit is it is not affected by the abnormal extreme values. It is not affected by the abnormal extreme values. It is not affected by the abnormal extreme values. If the values are high, it cannot be affected. It can be easily calculated. Okay. The next third one. It can be easily calculated for open end class intervals. It can be easily calculated for open end class intervals. See here, it can be easily calculated for open end class interval. What is open end class interval? If in a class, if the lower and upper class limits are not specified, then it is said to be open end class interval. For example, below 10, above 10, more than 10, less than 10, whatever, etc. These are said to be open end class intervals. Okay, here it can be easily calculated for open end class interval. Okay, here we want only median class or we want only quartile class. Okay, therefore here it can be easily calculated for open end class intervals. We want only quartile class. Okay, the next drawbacks of demerits of quartile deviation. Demerits of quartile deviation. Demerits, drawbacks of quartile deviation. Here the first one, it is not based on all the values. Here it is not based on, it is not based on all the values. It is not based on all the values. Okay, it takes only that is quartile class. It takes only quartile class. Okay, it is not based on all the values. Okay, suppose if the problem is based on ungrouped data, so means if only x values are given, then we want only middle values, that is quartiles. Okay, for example, 4.5th observation, 5th observation, 6th observation, 7th observation. Okay, like this. Okay, therefore it is not based on all the values. Okay, next, second one, second one here, it cannot be used for further statistical analysis. It cannot be used for further mathematical treatment or further statistical analysis. It cannot be used for further mathematical treatment. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅನಾಲಿಸಿಸ್ನಾಗ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಇಟ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕಲ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಅನಾಲಿಸಿಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಮೆರಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿಮೆರಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ವಾರ್ಟೈಲ್ ಡಿವಿಯೇಷನ್. ಎಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಮೆರಿಟ್ಸ್? ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಮೆರಿಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈಸಿ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಅಬ್ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್. ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್, it can be easily calculated for open end class intervals. Okay, the next drawbacks, the first one is it is not based on all the values. It takes only quartile classes and middle values. Okay, the next one, second, it cannot be used for further mathematical treatment or further mathematical or further statistical analysis. These are the merits and demerits of quartile deviation. Okay, one more thing, while calculating quartile deviation, quartiles or quartile deviation, the frequencies should be converted into less than cumulative frequencies, less than LCF. Okay, again, one more, while calculating quartiles, the inclusive class intervals should be converted into exclusive class intervals. While calculating quartile deviation, the inclusive class intervals should be converted into exclusive class intervals. Inclusive means 0 to 9, 10 to 19, 20 to 29, like etc. up to so on. Okay, here it should be converted into exclusive. Exclusive means 0 to 10, 10 to 20. Okay, if the lower class limit of the one, if the upper class limit of one class is repeated as the lower class limit, then it is said to be exclusive. Inclusive, not repeated. 0 to 9, 10 to 19. Here, if one of the upper class limit is not repeated as the lower class limit, then it is said to be inclusive. If it is repeated, then it is said to be exclusive. Here, the inclusive class intervals must be converted into exclusive class intervals. Okay, it is about quartile deviation or semi-interquartile range. Okay, now let us start the problems based on range and quartile deviation. Okay, here the first problem is, see, first one, calculate range, first calculate range calculate range calculate range and coefficient of range, coefficient of range for the following data. For the following data, okay, here 130, here they are given values 139, 151, 151, again 151, 157, 158, 160, 161, 162, 165, 167, and last one is 175. Calculate range and coefficient of range. Here solution. Okay, what is the range? The difference between highest values and lowest values said to be range. Here range is denoted by R. R equal to what? H minus L. Range is H minus L. Okay, here the highest value is what? See, 139, 150, 151, up to so on, increasing order means. Okay, here highest value is 175 and lowest value is 139. Here 175 minus 139. How much? Here it is 36. R equal to 36. Next, you have to find coefficient of range. Okay, how to calculate coefficient of range? That is H minus L divided by H plus L. H minus L is 175 minus 139 divided by 175 plus 139. Here 175 minus 139 is 36 divided by 175 plus 139 is 314. Here 36 divided by 314 is 0.114. It is a coefficient of range. Coefficient of R, that is coefficient of range. Here what is range? Range is the highest value to the lowest value, highest value minus lowest value, and coefficient of range is H minus L divided by H plus L. What is the coefficient of range? Here it is the ratio of absolute measures of dispersion to an suitable average is the coefficient of range, that is H minus L divided by H plus L. Then substitute the values, then we will get the answer. Okay, the next one, second, calculate interquartile range and semi interquartile range for the following data. Calculate interquartile range and semi interquartile range. Range for the following data. Okay, here they are given data as 11, 15, 16, 9, 14, 19, 10, 12, 8, 17, 20, 23 and 22. See, here calculate interquartile range and semi-interquartile range. Okay, here then how to calculate interquartile range? What is interquartile range? That is the difference between the upper and lower quartile is said to be interquartile range. Okay, here solution. Here the first you have to find interquartile range. Okay, here what is the interquartile range? That is difference between upper and lower, Q3 minus Q1. Here first you have to find Q3 and Q1 values. You have to find Q3 and Q1 values. Okay, here the data are of type ungrouped data. Ungrouped data. Okay, here, what is the first step? Here, the given observations should be converted into. Here, the given observations should be converted into ascending order. Okay, here, arrange the given data into ascending order. Arrange the given data into ascending order. Okay, here ascending order, the first value is 8, 9, the next 10, 11, 12, 13 is not there, the next 14, 15, 16, 16 over, the next one is 17, 18 is not there, the next 19, 20, 22 and 23. There are 13 observations are there. Okay, here, first you have to find first quartile Q1, then how to calculate quartile, that is Qi equal to I into n plus 1 by 4th observation. I into n plus 1 by 4th observation. Then substitute I equal to 1. It is Q1 equal to 1 into n is number of observations are 13. 13 plus 1 divided by 4th observation. It can be split into third value plus 0.5. Third value plus remaining is what? 0.5. 3 plus 0.5 is 3.5 into 3.5 line the observation is 3 to 4. Here upper is 4. That is fourth value minus lower is third value. Then here third value is what? 10. 10 plus 0.5 into fourth value is 11. 11 minus third value is 10. That is 11 minus 10 is 1. 1 into 0.5 is 0.5. 0.5 plus 10 is 10.5. It is a Q1 value. The next we have to find a Q2 value. Q3. Q3 equal to 3 into 13 plus 1 by 4th observation. Here 13 plus 1 is 14. 14 divided by 4 is 3.5. 3.5 into 3. 3 is 9 plus 1.5. 10.5. It is 10.5th observation. Here it can be split into 10th value plus remaining is what? 0.5. The next 10.5 line the observation is 11 to 10. That is 11 is upper. That is 11th value minus 10th value. Here 10th value is what? 19 plus 0.5. 11th value is 20 and 10th value is 19. Here 20 minus 19 is 1. 1 into 0.5 is 0.5. 0.5 plus 19 is 19.5. It is about Q3. That is third quartile. Okay, the next one. Here you have already studied about how to calculate quartiles up to this Q1, Q2 and Q3. Okay, the next we have to calculate interquartile range. Interquartile range and semi-interquartile range. What is interquartile range? Okay, here interquartile range equal to it is that half of the difference between upper and lower quartile. Interquartile range is Q3 minus Q1. Q3 is 19.5 minus 10.5. See here 19.5 minus 10.5 is 9. It is interquartile range is 9. The next you have to calculate semi-interquartile range. Now how to calculate semi-interquartile range? That is semi-interquartile range is denoted by QD. That is QD or semi-interquartile, right? Semi-interquartile range equal to Q3. It is the half of the difference between interquartile range. That is Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. That is Q3 minus Q1 is 9. 9 divided by 2 is 4.5. Here semi-interquartile range is 4.5 or QD quartile deviation is 4.5. Okay, here the data are of type ungrouped case. Okay, the next problem, third one, calculate coefficient of quartile deviation from the data given below. Coefficient of quartile deviation from the data given below. Okay, here they are given x with respect to f value. Okay, here it is in the type of ungrouped data. Here the class intervals are not given. So, okay, it is a discrete case. If the class intervals are given, then it is said to be continuous case. Okay, here discrete case. Here then how to calculate coefficient of quartile deviation? What is the formula? Coefficient of quartile deviation equal to Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. Okay. Now have to calculate Q3 and Q1 values. Okay. Here while frequencies are given, the frequencies should be converted into LCF, less than cumulative frequencies. Okay. Here the LCF, frequency first time and LCF first time both are same. 3. 3 plus 5 is 8. 8 plus 10 is 18. 18 plus 12 is 30. 30 plus 6 is 36, 36 plus 4 is 40. Here capital N is equal to 40. Here you have to find a first quartile Q1 equal to 1 into N plus 1 by 4th observation. See here, 1 into n plus 1, 1, n is what, 10, 40, 40 plus 1 is 41, that is 40 plus 1 divided by 4th observation. Here 41 divided by 4, 40 plus 1 is 41, 41 divided by 4 is 10.25, that is 10.25th observation. 10.25th observation. Okay, here 10.25th observation. Okay, suppose the x with respect to frequencies are given. Here the value of x corresponding to the quartile. See here 10.25th observation. Here we have to refer LCF. 10.25th observation lie in the LCF is 3, 8. Okay, here 9 to 18 belongs to 6. Here 10.5 belongs to 8 to 18. Means here x is that is 6. Therefore, it is a Q1 value. Q1 equal to what? Directly you have to write Q1 equal to 6. The next one, Q3. That is 3 into N plus 1 by 4th observation. Here 3 into N is 40, 40 plus 1 is, okay, 41 divided by 4 is 10.25. 3 into 10.25th observation. Here 3 into 10.25th observation is 30.75. 3 into 10.25 is 30.75th observation. See here 30.75, you have to refer LCF. 30.75 means, okay, here 31 to 36 belongs to 10. Here our result is about 30.75 belongs to 30 to 36. Okay, here the value of x corresponding to the quartile class, quartile, that is Q3 equal to 10. Q3 equal to 10. Now next you have to find coefficient of quartile deviation. Quartile deviation Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. Q3 is 10 minus 6, Q1 is 6, 10 plus 6. Here 10 minus 6 is 4, 4 divided by 14. 4 divided by 14 is 0.2857. 0.2857. Here 0.28. Coefficient of QD equal to coefficient of QD equal to 0.27. Here once again, here they are given x with respect to f values. While calculating QD, the frequency should be converted into LCF. The next, here only they are given x with respect to f values. Therefore, you have to apply Q1 equal to, it is in the case of discrete case, that is Q1 equal to I into n plus 1 by 4th observation, here I is 1, first you have to find first quartile, then substitute I equal to 1, 1 into 40 plus 1 divided by 4, that is we will get 10.25th observation. Okay. Here class intervals are not given, therefore the x value is the quartile, that is the value of x corresponding to the quartile. Okay, here 10.25th observation, then you have to refer LCF 10.25th. Okay, here 9 to 18 belongs to, okay, 9 to 18, okay, here belongs to 10.2, say 9 to 18 belongs to 6th observation. Okay, therefore Q1 equal to 6, then again same, you have to apply Q3 equal to 3 into n plus 1 by 4th observation, then substitute the values, then we will get to 30.75th observation. Okay, 31 to 36 belongs to 10, our result is what? 31.75 belongs to 10, that is Q3 equal to 10. Then you have to apply formula Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1, then substitute the values, then you will get the 0.28 is the answer. Okay, the next fourth one, calculate an appropriate measure of dispersion from the following data. Here they are given, here find a semi interquartile range. Okay, here they are given class interval with respect to frequencies. Here they are given class intervals are less than 25, less than 30, less than 35. Okay, we should convert into inclusive. Sorry, exclusive. Okay, less than 25 means you have to take 20 to 25, less than 25 means you have to take 25 to 30, up to so on, 50 to 55 with respect to frequencies. Okay, here while calculating frequencies should be converted into while calculating quartile, the frequencies should be converted into LCF. Here they are given 10, 25, 75, 130, 170, 189, 200. Okay, here they are given LCF, not frequencies. Okay, here the frequencies are increasing or decreasing order. Okay, here they are given LCF. Here the less than cumulative frequencies are always increasing order. Means here they are given LCF values. It should be converted into frequency. Okay, here the frequency per time and LCF per time both are same. 10. 25 minus 10 is 15, 75 minus 25 is 50, 130 minus 75 is 55, 170 minus 130 is 40, 118 minus 170 is 19, the next 200 minus 189 is 11. Okay, the next one is we have to find the first quartile and second quartile class. Okay, here we have to find first quartile class, that is Q1 class equal to Q1 class, the class corresponding to the, well, otherwise you have to find n by 4th observation, find n by 4th observation, n by 4th and 3n by 4th observation. Okay, see here n by 4 is n is what? 200, sorry, n equal to 200, here 200 divided by 4 is 50. The next 3n by 4, 3 into 50, n by 4 is 50, that is 150. Here you have to find the first quartile class, that is Q1 class equal to class corresponding to class corresponding to, that is 50th observation. Here the class corresponding to 50th observation, that is, okay, 50th observation is what? See, here the class corresponding to 50th observation. 50th observation, we have to refer LCF. Okay, 50th observation. See, here 50th observation is, see, 10 to 25. Okay, 26 to 75 belongs to 30 to 35. It belongs to 30 to 35. Okay, here the class corresponding to 50th observation is 30 to 35. Is 30 to 35. Okay, the next one, Q3 class equal to class corresponding to 3 and by 4th observation, that is 150th observation. 150th observation is, see, here one, we have to refer LCF. 150th observation is 131 to 170 belongs to 40 to 45. Here, the next you have to apply formula, that is Q1 equal to L plus 1N by 4 minus CF by F into C. Here, what is L? L is the lower limit of the quartile class. And CF is cumulative frequency of the preceding class. F is the frequency of the quartile class. And C is width of the quartile class. Okay. Here, L is, say, lower limit of the, it is Q1 class. It is, next, Q3. L is the lower limit of the quartile class is 30 plus 1n by 4. Here 1n by 4 is what? 50. That is 50 minus cumulative frequency of the preceding class. Cumulative frequency is 75. Preceding class is 25. Cumulative frequency of the preceding class means above class. That is CF is 25. Divided by frequency of the quartile class, first quartile class, that is 50 into, say, is width of the quartile class. 30 to 35 is 5. Here 30 plus 50 minus 25. 50 minus 25 is 25. 25 divided by 50 is 0.5. 0.5 into 5 is 2.5. 2.5 plus 30 is, see here, 50 minus 25 is 25 divided by 50 into 5. Here 30 plus 25 by 50 is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into 5 is 2.5. That is 32.5 is the Q1 value. The next Q3 equal to L plus 3N by 4 minus CF into C divided by F. Here L, lower limit of the third quartile class. Lower limit of the third quartile class is 40. 40 plus, okay, 3N by 4 is 150 minus CF, cumulative frequency of the third quartile class. Cumulative frequency is 170. Cumulative frequency of the preceding class means, that is above class, is 130. 150 minus 130 divided by frequency of the third quartile class is 40 into width of the, that is 5, width of the class interval. Then 40 plus 150 minus 130 is 20. 20 divided by 40 is 0.5 into 5 is 2.5. That is 40.2.5. Okay, then we will get 42.5. Q3 equal to what? 42.5. Okay. Next, we have to find what? Semi-interquartal range. Okay. Semi-interquartal range is, that is QD equal to Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. Here, Q3 is 42.5 minus Q1 value is 32.5 divided by 2. Here 42.5 minus 32.5 is 10. 10 divided by 2 is 5. Here semi-interquartile range, that is QD equal to 5. Semi-interquartile range is 5. Okay, it is the semi-interquartile range. Okay, yes, got it. Here they are given class interval with respect to frequency. Here class interval should be converted into frequencies. Sorry, LCF. They are given LCF values. We should convert it into frequencies. Okay. So next, we want Q1 and Q3 class. Then how to calculate Q1 class? That is n by 4th observation lies in the class interval. That is 50th observation is 30 to 35. Yeah, then L is the lower limit of the quartile class, and CF is cumulative frequency of the preceding class, that is 25, and frequency is 50, and width of the class interval is 5. Then substitute the values, then we will get answer. Then you have to apply QD equal to Q3, that is semi-interquartile range formula. QD equal to Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. Then substitute the values, then we will get QD equal to 5. Okay. The next one, okay, it is fifth problem. Next one is fourth problem. Okay, here in fourth problem, calculated appropriate measure of dispersion. Here they are given class interval with respect to frequencies. Class intervals are less than 340 to 370, 370 to 400, 400 to 430, 430 and above. And they are given frequencies 14, 62, 99, 80, 97. Okay, here it is less than 340 means it is the, which one it is? Less than 340 open end class interval, it should be converted into exclusive, that is 340. Width is 30 minutes, you have to take 310 to 340 first class interval, 310 to 340. 340 to 370, width is 30 each. Okay, here they are given frequencies, it should be converted into LCF. Okay, it is homework. You have to find appropriate measure of dispersion, means you have to find QD, quartile deviation, QD values. Okay, QD equal to Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. Okay, you have to find first Q3 values and Q1 values. Okay, then substitute the values, then you get the answer. Okay, next, sixth one, if lower and interquartile range of data are 31.75 and 30.88, find the upper quartile and QD. Here they are given lower quartile. Lower quartile is denoted by what? Q1 solution. Lower quartile is denoted by Q1. Q1 equal to what? 31.75 and interquartile range. Interquartile, that is Q3 minus Q1 value, they are given. Interquartile range is 30.88. Find upper quartile and QD. Okay, here upper quartile and QD, quartile deviation. Okay, here we know that Q3 minus Q1 equal to 30.88. We know that Q3 minus Q1 equal to 30.88. Here Q1 values, they are given directly. Q3, put Q3 equal to minus Q1 equal to what? 31.75 equal to 30.88. okay, here Q3 equal to 30.88 plus 31.75. here 30.88 plus 31.75 is 62.63. here Q3 value equal to 62.63. next we have to find QD. QD equal to Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. Q3 value is what? Sorry, Q3 minus Q1 value 30.88 divided by 2. That is 15.44. QD equal to what? 15.44. Okay, it is the answer. Here they are given lower quartile, that is Q1 value is 31.75, and interquartile range, that is Q3 minus Q1 is 30.88. Find upper quartile and QD. Upper quartile is Q3. We know that Q3 minus Q1 equal to 30.8, then substitute Q1 value, then we get Q3 equal to 62.63. Then find quartile deviation, QD equal to Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. Then we will get 15.4 is the answer. Okay. The next class, we have to discuss about mean deviation and coefficient of mean deviation. Okay. Thank you.